linear variable differential transformer, LVDT, is a common type of electromechanical transducer or sensor which is used to convert the linear motion of an object to which it is attached into a proportional electrical signal. LVDT offers good accuracy, high resolution, good sensitivity, and relatively zero mechanical friction, which makes preferable sensors for measuring the linear displacement. Construction. A typical LVDT consists of a cylindrical transformer that carries three coils, one primary coil at the center of the transformer, and on either side of the primary coil, there are two secondary coils. The two secondary coils have an equal number of turns, but are opposite to each other. A movable soft iron core slides within the hollow space of the cylindrical transformer, and therefore, affects the magnetic coupling between the primary and secondary coil. The soft iron core carries a projecting arm, which is then attached to the object whose displacement needs to be measured. Principle of operation. When the primary coil is given an AC supply, current flows through the primary coil, and it further induces the current in the secondary coil according to Faraday's law of induction. Thus, EMF generated in one of the secondary coils B, E1, and the EMF generated in other secondary coil B, E2. Thus the net EMF will be equal to E1 minus E2. Since the coils are wound opposite to each other. This is the basic working principle of LVDT. If you are enjoying this video, please give this video a thumbs up, and if you are new to ADTW Learn, click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification to get more informative videos like this. Working. Based on the position of the soft iron core, there could be three cases. Case 1. When the core is at the center. When the core is at the center, equal voltage is induced in both the secondary coils, that is, EMF E1, in the secondary coil S1, and EMF E2, in other secondary coil S2. Since the two coils are equal in turns, and but of opposite magnitude. Therefore, this EMF generated will cancel each other, and the net EMF generated will be null. That is, output EMF, E equal to E1 minus E2, which will be equal to zero. Therefore, this position of the core is also sometimes called a null position. Case 2. When the core is at left-hand side. Since the iron core is closer to the secondary coil S1, more flux links with the secondary coil S1. Thus, output EMF of the secondary coil S1 would be greater than the EMF generated in the secondary coil S2. Therefore, the net output voltage from the secondary coil will be positive, that is, output EMF will be equal to S1 minus S2, which will be equal to positive. Case 3. When the core is on the right-hand side. When the iron core is on the right-hand side from its null position, the flux linking the coil S2 of the secondary coil is more as compared to the flux linking the S1 coil. Therefore, greater EMF is generated in coil S2. Thus EMF in coil S2, that is, E2 will be greater than the EMF induced in coil S1, that is, E1, and hence the net output voltage will be negative. Thus, we can conclude that the amount of EMF induced in the pair of the secondary winding is proportional to the displacement of the movable iron core. This output voltage can be measured to determine the relative position or displacement of the iron core. The output voltage is the linear function of the core displacement. Advantages of LVDT. High range. LVDT has got a high range of displacement measurement. No frictional losses, thus accuracy of the LVDT is high. With high output and high sensitivity, the output of the LVDT does not require any further amplification. It has got low hysteresis, thus has got good repeatability. Rugged in construction. Limitations. LVDTs are sensitive to stray magnetic field, hence need to be protected from stray magnetic fields during their operation. Large displacement is required for producing appreciable differential output. It is affected by the temperature and vibrations. Applications. LVDT can be used as a secondary transducer or sensor for measuring force, weight, pressure, etc. Brain probing in medical applications. To provide displacement feedback for hydraulic systems. To measure the distance between the approaching metals during friction welding. I hope you have understood how LVDTs work. It takes lots of effort to make such informative videos. You can help ADTW Learn to make more videos by joining our channel and contributing to developing more such videos. Your support will help us make great educational videos. Other ways of helping us is by sharing our videos with your friends. Thank you.